What's up, fam? We're going to do a quick one. I'm going to try to see who I can get through before I got to bust out of this car and move on. But it's just going to be a quick three cards. Advice from Spirit. We shouldn't really have to do any tarot in this. Hold on, let me cut the deck. I'm going to start with Capricorn Spirit. Advice for Capricorn for today going into, this weekend. You have the Chariot in the reverse, the Moon card, and then you have the Queen of Cups, Capricorn. It looks like some of you could be expecting congratulations. You're not sure upon the arrival of when your child is going to come. It could be that you're not sure of your conception date, maybe. You might be coming into information about your conception date. With the Chariot in the reverse, it could be that somebody's being taken away from you with this Moon card being here, followed by you as this Queen of Cups. Please, bottom of the deck is Judgment, Queen of Pentacles, Two of Pentacles. You're teeter-tottering on something. It's like you're up and down with it. It could be a King of Swords, possibly. This could be the child's father. One card for the Chariot is the Queen of Swords. So, why is the Queen of Swords here with the Chariot card in reverse, Spirit, for Capricorn? Okay, so I don't know if you guys may be dealing with somebody else that's already in a partnership or a marriage. We have the Queen of Swords out here as well as the King of Swords. Right now, the Queen of Swords with the Chariot in the reverse seems like it could be like this person is coming to present some type of factual information, but it's not the information that you want to hear with the Chariot being in reverse, Capricorn. You have the Four of Cups, you have the King of Swords, and you have this Eight of Wands right here, which definitely looks like that, right? And what it looks like is that this Queen of Swords is speaking about you taking possibly this masculine figure away from her. They feel that they have some type of obviously soulmate connection with how those two wands meet up at the top and are evenly length on the sides and whatnot. This can also indicate too that this person is coming to tell you something that may be false, which is, hey, my person told me that they've been trying to keep, away from you, or they're not giving into what you want, but you keep trying to link yourself with them, or it's like you can't have that individual, their mind, basically. So, this could be something that you may be coming into, Capricorn. Spirit, what is your advice for Capricorn in this situation? It looks like you may be at your baby shower sitting down with the Moon card. People could be surrounding you. It could just come up. I'm not sure. You could be somewhere just sitting down. Your advice is the Three of Swords. One card at a time, please, Spirit. Sorry. The Page of Pentacles and the Eight of Wands. So what I'm getting here is with the Three of Swords and this arrow going straight through the heart is, one, yes, it's painful. It's 353. It's a third party interference to some degree. Three of Wands on the bottom of, the deck. So some of you could have been in something where maybe you didn't know that somebody was married or connected to someone else. Regardless, what they're saying is to face the reality of the situation with the white and the black. The truth of the matter is obviously in the heart of the situation. The heart of the situation is you're having a child. Or you I could say this is about ideas as well, but I really strongly do feel like it's about a child. However, if this is ideas, it's ideas. Regardless, you have this, and what you need to do is be happy about that with the Page of Pentacles. That, child with this, what do you call those? This document. It's like, that's theirs. And this is a fresh new start, right? So even though it does pain you and hurt you to have to face the reality of things, 444, at the end of the day, you can and you will be able to move forward by accepting and embracing the love within the child that you've created and the fresh new start that y'all have. And now you have this with this individual here, with who's in your stomach, or even with the idea. This could be you synchronizing with yourself, Capricorn. 5:05 on the clock. Thank you, Capricorn. All right, this next one is for Aquarius spirit. Advice for Aquarius, you know, three cards for what they're going to be experiencing the next few days. Some advice for them, spirit. Aquarius spirit, Aquarius collective. You guys have the Eight of Wands, a bond. Excuse me, one card at a time, please. I'm sorry, 2, 4, 6. That's the 7, I apologize. 7 as well earlier for you, Capricorn. The Chariot in the reverse. The Hangman in the reverse. Okay. I don't even know I did that. All right. So, Aquarius, you have the Eight of Wands, the Chariot in the middle, in the reverse, and the Hangman in the reverse. All right, Aquarius, coming up for this weekend or today, leading into this weekend, it looks like y'all have some type of bond or connection with someone, somebody. You know what I'm saying? It to you must be spiritual because you guys both meet at the middle. So maybe y'all are both twin to one another in some type of shape, form, or fashion. With the Chariot card in the reverse, however, it looks like you are hoping for, like, how these two are looking at each other to be able to have this and to be able to do this one another. But it looks like somebody could be locked up or be choosing to remain silent. With the Hangman in the reverse, this person is able to stand up, but it looks like they're choosing to personally keep their mouth shut. It could be that they're in some type of prison or even a mental prison. Therefore, them coming towards you may or may not happen, okay? With the Chariot in the reverse and the Hangman in the reverse, why? What is the Chariot in the reverse, spirit? What does that represent? The Chariot in reverse would have been you having this fresh new offer with the Hierophant and this Page of Pentacles between you and this individual. Can you give me one card for the Chariot, please? That's not coming in right now. The Emperor. So it could be that there's a judge or someone who is basically not allowing this union to happen. The Hangman in reverse, spirit. For Aquarius, one card, please. For Aquarius, the Hangman in reverse is the Four of Pentacles, holding back. It's holding back. I mean, it's clarifying the Hangman in reverse. So while somebody's not talking, they don't get to move forward. This Emperor is choosing to withhold something from this individual. And in turn that, they can't come towards you, or y'all won't be able to have this Eight of Wands. Eight of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck, the Queen of Pentacles, and the Four of Cups. You as well, like, people are talking maybe about you, Aquarius, or it could be work-wise, about how you maintain, how you're stable, but how you're not, like, in a commitment with someone else, possibly. What is the advice that you would like to provide for Aquarius at this time, spirit? Justice, the Fool, and the Five of Cups. If this Emperor basically took from you by not allowing this release, or like with the Chariot being in the reverse, not allowing whatever this change is to happen, with the Five of Cups here, it's like trying to get away. This person is trying to get away. Like, oh, I took this. I'm sneaking out. But the whole time, they're not. They're actually running into you. They're not looking where they're going. And the thing is that justice does not pick or choose, you know, which type of person gets to receive it. Justice is an all-around contract for everyone. At the bottom of the deck, you do have the Devil card here. So, Yeah, I think that what Spirit is saying is to allow justice to happen as necessary, Aquarius, because as you allow justice to happen and move forward, justice is you just moving forward and getting through, you're going to end up running to the same individual. And the devil, like I said, is on the bottom of the deck. This person may turn around scared, trying to ask you to help them. You never know. Pisces, this is for my Pisces spirit. All right. We have the Empress Pisces. We have Judgment Pisces. And we have the Sun Pisces. So Pisces, it looks like today coming into the weekend, there's some type of clarity or truth that comes out with the Sun. And with this clarity and truth, now the person who is being judged will receive said judgment, okay? On the bottom of the deck is the Page of Swords. It is the Ace of Swords. And it is the Nine, I believe, of Wands, or the Eight of Wands. I think this is the Eight of Wands. I apologize. So this is coming quicker. I get mixed up on those two Wand cards. My apologies, everyone. But somebody has seen something. They know, they seen it. They know it's the truth. I'm sorry, they seen it right here with this Page of Swords. They know it's the truth and they run it. I don't know if they seen this in a video, if they saw it online, if they were a present witness, 1111 Pisces, but somebody seen something, they heard something, they could prove the truth that's going on, right? So it looks like you're under some type of judgment in these upcoming days and whatnot, but truth and clarity will come out. What is the Sun about, Spirit? It's about a few things. It is about justice. The Sun brings justice and it also brings death. So it brings, you know, some type of alignment. You have the Emperor on the bottom of the deck, the Chariot on the bottom of the deck, and the Four of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. So you have an Emperor who was supposed to come in and be of some type of assistance, but they chose to hold out. You have the Four of Wands. This could be pertaining to your home, Pisces. Judgment card, Spirit. What is the Judgment card? The judgment is about a lie. So somebody told a lie about something, possibly from the past, with the Death card resurfacing with justice. There could be some type of lie that had been told. And I guess what I would ask, it says Two of Wands, so there's a path or a choice someone has, you know. So with this, Spirit, what is the advice you would like to offer Pisces? All right, Pisces, the advice coming, which is the offer, is the Three of Swords in the reverse, the Five of Wands, and the Judgment card. With the Three of Wands in reverse, somebody is bitter, somebody is upset, but also it could be with this, you know, they could, instead of looking at this, they're accepting this truth, right? And this is what hurts. And this is what causes them to start to go and maybe investigate the situation or to choose to surrender into something else. This can also be an individual acting in nasty manner with the Three of Swords in the reverse, 1323 on the clock. This individual, you know, being hurt and being bitter about this situation's interference and, you know, them making a willing choice to choose a fiery path or a fiery road that they would like to go down. What is the judgment for this individual over here? Just period. The Lovers. A choice and a decision. The Six of Cups. And the Three of Pentacles. So for the individual who's realizing the truth and whatnot in a situation, they're going to have a choice in who they partner up with or who they choose to deal with in a romantic way. They're going to be able to speak to the Most High and ask, you know, for direction, guidance, and whatnot, but as well as help with filling up said cup. And they're going to be able to start planting seeds towards that. Okay? Thank you, Pisces. Aries, you're up next. This is for Aries spirit for today, leading into this weekend. Advice about what's coming up for them that they need to be aware of. You have the Ten of Pentacles. You have the Nine of Cups. And you have the King of Pentacles in the reverse. King of Pentacles in reverse. Somebody's stability might be a little wonky or funky. It's in the reverse. So maybe someone's unable to. It could be due to emotional. So even though you may have the physical stability of abundance of dollars and coins and whatnot, 1515, there could be something that's highly emotional that you're keeping hidden to yourself, Aries, that keeps you, you know what I'm saying, locked away. It keeps you, you know what I'm saying, keeping all this love for yourself. But you're also supposed to, you know, you have this Ten of Pentacles here. It also keeps you from reaching the highest amount of success. Right now, it looks like you're trying to introduce balance in, you know what I'm saying, some type of temperance energy, Sagittarian energy. One card for the King of Pentacles in the reverse with the Y. I did see the Tower card try to pop out, so some of you may have something come up. Eight of Swords, something that blindsided you, maybe an unexpected situation, like a cost, a toll, child support, I don't know. And this Nine of Cups is something that's been going on for a long time. It's a feeling you've had for a long time. Four of Wands on the bottom of the deck, Ace of Cups in the Moon. It is not out yet, but it does deal with how you understand and accept source and love and how you're able to have that within self, but as well as within your family with the Four of Wands. The Ten of Pentacles for Aries spirit. So many cards. Yeah, the Four of Wands. So this will have to do something with your family and the overall stability that's going on. There could be something that you don't know about, Aries, or something that you find out about this weekend about, you know what I'm saying, an instability and why it is like that. It could be you finding out that you've been making choices and decisions blindly based off of what others have been saying about, you know what I'm saying, your stability and your family life. It also here, though, one thing I could say for certain, two things for sure, Aries, is that you're harboring something deep within that is emotional that you keep to yourself, and it's unfortunately holding back your wings from you reaching your full potential. All right, thank you, Aries. Taurus, advice for Taurus for today leading into this weekend, spirit, what they need to know. Three cards, please. You have the Queen of Cups in the reverse. The Eight of Wands. And Justice. Someone is not loving. Someone is not motherly. Someone does not give a ha ha. You know what I'm saying? They don't. And it looks like someone has their eyes set on that Justice card right here. Taurus, feminine, I believe, masculine as well, but feminine showing up on the card. But there is some type of justice that you are coming into. You are not doing this to make someone feel good. You are not doing this to make someone enjoy themselves. This has strictly nothing to do with anyone else. This is about what you want and what you see coming. And it looks like you're not going to be giving that lovingliness about yourself to anyone else at this moment. 1818 on the bottom of the deck is the Wheel of Fortune. The Five of Swords and Temperance. There has been so much mental confusion that has probably projected your mind towards for quite some time with the Wheel of Fortune being here. Angels had to step in with Temperance and the Star and offer some type of assistance with you with the Five of Pentacles, some type of help. This could even be physical angels. This could be your supernatural angels. This could be your dream angels. It could be however you see it, but the angels that's good, they've been coming through trying to help. Please explain, Spirit, Queen of Cups in the reverse. Is this good or bad? What is this justified for the Taurus coming up this weekend or today? Yeah, it is. You got the same cards that just came out, Taurus. The Wheel of Fortune, followed by the Temperance and the Five of Swords. The Queen of Cups is not loving nor caring towards others. And I don't mean to try to cuss people out, beating people up, or doing anything to anybody. But you're not going to be in this manner because somebody has literally went out their way to try to create that chaotic nature, that mental instability where you could not think, where things were everywhere, where it was hard to, you know what I'm saying, be like, what's going on? Or I feel and I believe this, but then now you're trying to come in and tell me about other stuff. And I don't know. Temperance card is here to provide some type of balance to the situation. One card for the Queen of Cups in reverse, spirit. Is the Three of Pentacles in reverse. You are not going to be planting seeds with nobody. Maybe that's why this Queen of Cups is in reverse, because if you thought that you got pregnant or you're going to get pregnant this weekend, it's a possibility that you're not, because you're not going to plant the seeds with them. You're not going to be doing the do, possibly. It could also be that you no longer want to build with the father of your child or the mother of your child, vice versa. But at the end of the day, someone emotionally has released it and let it go, and everything that went with that person. So whatever seeds was planted that ground before the rain came through and washed up and it got all flooded and the sea started flowing all around, and now somebody gotta take care of it. It's not you, Taurus, anymore. You no longer want to pick up messes. The Eight of Wands for the Taurus spirit today going into this weekend is the same card as Aries, which is this Nine of Cups. Again, it's like you confronting what has been hidden for a long time or buried deep in the casket, what has kept your wings clipped. Hangman on the bottom of the deck, King of Cups. This could be dealing with your father, you know what I'm saying? And it could be dealing with prison or a mental prison. The Justice card, spirit for the Taurus, is the Moon in the reverse. This is what's coming out. What's coming out is that somebody may have moved too fast. The Justice is the Moon in reverse. It means that the secret that someone didn't talk about is going to come out, Taurus. And the secret is about possibly somebody who moved too fast. They ended up possibly impregnating someone else. It's a possibility that this mother lost their child, the seeds, Three of Pentacles, planting the seeds. And